Hey y'all. So first, welcome to my page, and I want to take a moment to just tell you a little bit about my story. Back in 2009, I graduated college with my MBA in accounting. I had got my first job. I was making about 40K, which at that time I thought was a lot of money. And then I got my first student loan bill. Yep, that's how my eyes was looking, real crazy. I owed a little bit over $60,000 in student loan debt. So, you know, those moments where people are questioning, like, should I go to college? Yeah, that was one of the moments I had after I was finished. Like, oh, who's about to pay this back? So I was barely making it work, paying when I could, just whatever. My attitude was real nonchalant about it at the time. And then my car was in an accident and I needed a new vehicle. So I'm thinking, like, you go to a dealership, you get a new vehicle. Simple, right? No, not that easy. So when I went down to the dealership, I found out that my credit score was not great, which is not surprising considering I didn't want to pay my student loans on time. And I also had a credit card when I was 18 and I was wild, crazy, and free with it. So reality set in quickly. So I knew I need a cosigner. Like, who's about to cosign this for me? So I went to my parents like, I need y'all to cosign this vehicle. And we probably would laugh about this story now, and then I didn't think it was funny at all. And they kind of chuckled at me, like, you real whatever with your money. Like, we're not sure we're gonna co-sign for you. So I really had to show them that I could afford these payments. So I had to sit down, collect all my information about all my expenses, and I created a budget. Now, my goal was to get a three-year car loan, so I created a three-year budget. This is what it looks like. This is how much money I can save. Like, I can do this. I brought them back to the table. I showed them what my plan was. Boom, bam. We did a business transaction. I walked away with a car. So I'm amped, right? I'm really excited. That's all good and great, except for the fact that I still had this credit score that I needed to deal with. So I started doing research on credit scores. How do I increase the score? What impacts my score? What's on my credit report? So I collected all this information. And once I actually had an understanding for it, it made it kind of easier to outline what I needed to do. Now remember, at the beginning of this video, I said I had an MBA in accounting. Even with that MBA in accounting, I still did not know before I did the research what I really needed to do. I started reaching out to credit card companies. I reached out to see if there was any way to do a settlement payment that was not going to negatively impact my credit report. So I did all these different things. And when I first started this journey, like, at one point I was embarrassed to say this, but I ain't. Like, I'm gonna be real with y'all. When I first started my journey of repairing my credit, I had a 550 credit score. 550, right? 550. I could not believe it. Like, I didn't even want to talk about it with people. It was just like, get it up, don't talk about it, be about it, and get your credit score up. So I did all of these steps that I'm really trying to show y'all on myself. Like, I am a product of my steps. And really through following those steps and keeping the budget that I had set, I was able to pay off my car loan in 2 years, even though it was a three-year loan. I was able to pay off student loan debt in 5 years, even though it was a 10-year term. Like, I was grinding. Y'all can do what I did. On top of the fact that I was doing that, I went back and got my admin certification, did not take out one loan, then went back and got my PhD. Yes, you heard right. I'm Dr. Gemsdropper up there, but I'm really just Dr. Ruby Harris in life. I went back and got my PhD, did not take out one additional loan. I currently live alone. I pay my own bills. I travel the world. I have leased two vehicles since that vehicle that I first needed my parents to help me with a long time ago. Your girl does it out here solo, with support from others. Don't get me wrong. I get emotional support from people, but financially, I just am out here and I follow the plan. I have traveled to Italy and Dubai and Africa I went to last year. I have some other big ticket items that I want to do. Like, it's tried and it's true. The process works, all right? If it can work on me, and I love to shop and be out here and do and see the world, I know it will work for you. I just need you to click below and set this appointment up. Like, help me help you. Like, I want to get your money right for you. let's get this money right together. Let's just live in this place where like we're blown daily about the things that we're able to do. So click below, and I can't wait to chat with each one of y'all.